I'm Matt from Demolition Ranch, and welcome to SHOT Show 2024 with Canadian Caliber here. All right. So we started, I guess I first got my first Maxim, it was a pistol, probably 4 or 5 years ago, and I've been shooting it since then. And then, you know, they've come out with some new stuff, and they've come out and showed us their guns, take them out to my place. And we always love hanging out with the Maxim guys. They're a fun group of guys. They make a cool product, and I mean, it speaks for itself. That's a hard question to answer. When I come to SHOT Show, I'm looking forward to seeing, you know, what the new products are, of course, which is what everybody says, but also just seeing all the faces of all the people that we talk to all the time in the industry but don't actually get to meet. It's really cool to, like, yeah, you know, talk to them in person, shake their hand, and say what's up. I just made that comment like an hour ago, though, as I walked past the Bearcat, and I was like, I need a Bearcat. I don't know why we don't own a Bearcat. It's actually irresponsible to not own a Bearcat. We always use this as a trip. We bring all our friends out here and employees out here, and we play around a lot. And so we go and gamble a little bit. We go to some shows. And so, yeah, we're just going to play. We have fun in Vegas. SHOT Show is not just about the SHOT Show for us. It's about just having fun for a few more days, and then we go back to normal life. I don't actually have any plans, but I've been to Canada once, been to Toronto, and it was great. Love it up there. All right, not in the winter, though.
No, not the winter.
I'm a Texas boy. I can't do that.
Everything's bigger and better in Texas.
Yep.
Thanks, Matt, for speaking of Canadian Caliber.
Yeah, thank you.
Hey, guys, this is The Collector. I'm out here with Canadian Caliber doing a nice short video on The Collector Show. This place is so badass. I mean, I'm going shopping today. That's basically what my goal is. During the shopping, I got to go see Taryn because I have to get more John Wick guns, actually. And him and I always get along, and we're actually going to be doing a collab here soon. For all the people I see that actually talk to me, they always want to know what I do for a living, which is mainly real estate, and they always want to know what I'm buying next. And that's usually what I'm here to do, is find out what I'm going to buy next. Hey guys, if you want to check out my channel and all of my toys and all my guns and gun ranges, just go to The Collector and subscribe.
What's up, my Canadian friends? Chris Cook of Under Armour here. We're at SHOT Show 2024. Just want to say a big shout out to the Canadian Caliber. We're here showing off our latest gear. We've got a lot of buzz in the booth. We've got a massive crowd out here on my left. We're giving away t-shirts. We're giving away e-bikes from Volcon. We're celebrating freedom today. We've got Purple Heart recipient JP Lane here and Spencer Milo. Wish you guys were here, but follow along for more coverage of the show.
Hey guys, I'm Dustin here at SHOT Show with Canadian Caliber, and we're gonna go over our master gun vise. So the cool thing about it is it's a ball and socket type vise. It's gonna spin 360 degrees. I can lock it into a bunch of different positions, but it can also lay down and be locked into a bunch of different positions. Now, everybody might be thinking, because it's ball and socket, that when I go to apply high amounts of torque, it may not work, and so people wanna stay away from it. However, we have a torque lock pin, and this pin actually intersects with two grooves that are on the bottom of the ball. So I'm gonna get it in here, line it up, and get her in there. Now this vise can handle up to 100 foot-pounds of torque, so barrel nuts or anything like that, it's gonna handle. But it also comes with our gun fit sleeves that are double-sided and pin in. So I can have a nice foam on one end, or I can turn it around and have a hard plastic that's gonna work on Picatinny, Arca Swiss, hold barrels, suppressors, anything like that. Or I can just get into regular standard jaws, all built in onto the master gun vise. So stay tuned. We're gonna be working and collaborating with Canadian Caliber on a big review on this.
Hey guys, this is Lucas from CZ. I'm here on a SHOT Show 2024 with the Canadian Calibers. And we wanna talk a little bit about the new CZ Shadow 2 Compact. So you guys probably know the CZ Shadow 2, the legendary pistol, which dominates the competition shooting world for quite some time already. But we wanted to bring something like sports car category of this pistol. So we have a compact body, aluminum frame, same features as you all know from your Shadow 2 competition pistols. But we also put the optic ready plate on the top as a standard feature, and also nice silver slash gray grips on a pistol. So it's a very smooth shooter. We also did some changes on the forcing cone. And on the end of the day, this pistol can shoot very, very good groups, even better than the predecessor. So you guys make sure you check this one out and make sure you order one, because they're going out fast. This model was released a few months ago, and we have lots of interest for this firearm. So if you want one, make sure you order one. because they go out fast.
Hey guys, Josh here for Holosun 2024 SHOT Show. We have an incredible amount of new stuff to cover for you guys. We're here exclusively with Canadian Caliper, taking a look at some of the coolest new products that we have. Obviously in front of us here, we have a slew. Some of these you may remember from last year. A lot of this on the table is brand new for this year that you haven't seen. So just to address a couple of things right off the bat, this DRS thermal and night vision unit, you guys have been asking for these for the longest times. We're finally shipping them now. The DRS night vision is gonna be shipping in the next 2 weeks. The thermal should follow pretty closely behind those, I would say the next 2 or 3 weeks. Obviously, the Canada release will take a little bit more time as we work them over there for you guys. So hopefully they'll be over there right around the beginning of Q2. This year, we have a lot of new stuff to steal the show. I would say probably the most prominent thing that everyone is really, really excited about is gonna be the Iris. The Iris is our new VCSEL laser that we have. And the cool thing about this one is that it uses that VSL technology to make the IR emitter really, really crisp and clean. But you're probably noticing on here, hey, there's a slider in the middle there. The cool thing about this is now it's adjustable. So you can take your beam pattern from very tight to very wide, allowing you to kind of focus that energy in for maybe a further target and then widening it up to see a lot more field of view on a closer range situation. We've taken our 321 series and looked at the feedback and the notes everybody had, and now we're just working on making things even easier to use. Additionally, the crane port, a little easier to use in the bottom there, so it's not wire management, it's dead center, easy access button on top. And the coolest thing about these is the price point. I'm not exactly sure what the price point is going to be for the Canadian marketplace, but for the US, we're looking at a price range of about $800. Additionally, if you like playing around in the dark, we have a new rifle flashlight that is coming out relatively soon as well too. This is called the Raid. And this features an 18650 rechargeable battery, so it's super easy to take in and out. You can magnetic charge it if you need to. But the really cool thing about this is that it's 80,000 candela and 1,000 lumens, so it has an incredible amount of throw, and it's honestly just a really, really robust rifle light. In the box included as well, you will have the pressure pad cap on the back for clicky activation, or you can just swap out the tail cap that uses a crane plug adapter, so you'll be able to run a dual lead or a single lead switch for this, no problem. And the price point is gonna be $180. So last year, you guys were so excited to see thermals. We took our thermal unit, we said, well, this is pretty cool. We shrunk it down this far. How far can we actually take this idea? Turns out pretty far, almost far enough to where we can fit this on a pistol now, and it's not a problem whatsoever. The coolest thing about this is that this here functions as the thermal sensor. This is mounted on the bottom in your flashlight slot for your pistol. This is gonna be mounted on top of your pistol slide for the red dot, and these wirelessly communicate with each other. So the thermal sensor is feeding the image to the red dot sight, but the cool thing is you can still use this as a very easy and traditional red dot sight. It's got an incredibly big window. So if you guys are looking for a 507C competition that's enclosed, well, now this might be an option for you because this thing is gonna be incredibly huge and enclosed. We have our new 6X magnifier. Just taking the three that we had previously, upping that now to 6 magnification, giving you guys a little bit of extra range, a little more oomph for your budget. And these aren't going to break the bank at all. These are coming in right around that $300 to $330 price point. So the last thing on the list that we have that's probably most exciting for people is going to be our PIDK flashlights. We took the PID series, we shrunk it by 20%. We have a light only and a laser option as well. Price points on these are gonna be very, very inexpensive. We're looking at $130 on the low end, and I wanna say $160 on the high end for the laser option. So just taking our form factor for the PIDs, making it a bit more smaller. I know the questions you guys are gonna have about holsters compatibility. We'll have more information as we get closer to the release of these, and we'll let you guys know exactly what they're gonna be compatible with, but we're hoping to make it work with everything on the market and make it simplistic for you guys. Everything on the table, except for the digital pistol thermal sights, is coming in Q2. So you guys will have access to this relatively soon this year. We wanna try to get this out for everybody to have more time to play with them because we have so much awesome stuff coming out. So definitely stay tuned to Canadian Caliber for more information about this. And if you guys have questions, definitely a good place to ask in the comments.
it's Carl Kozak. I'm with Core Essentials here at SHOT Show 2024. Just want to say thanks to Canadian Caliper for doing a little promo for us. Yeah, this is our booth. We're at 41019. We're showing off some of our EDC belts, our executive protection, our competition belts, battle belts, duty belts, all of which have a ratcheting mechanism that allows you to micro adjust the belt. So you just pop open your release tab right here, and the belt, instead of holes, or Velcro, you've got a track. The track just zips through the buckle right here and allows you to adjust the belt to your exact waist size, because your waist is changing throughout the day. After you eat, if you go to the gym and work out, it's always changing slightly here and there. So this allows you to get a perfect fit every time. All of our gun belts also are reinforced with our power core center, which is virtually indestructible. So come check us out at coreessentials.com, and stay tuned, because Canadian Caliper is going to do a little bit more of a review and promo on the belt and give you some more information. Thank you.
Hey, my name is Scotty Banks. I'm here at SHOT Show 2024 with Canadian Caliber. Here to talk about the brand new Glock G49. So what the G49 consists of, it has a Glock 19 length grip, but it has a G17 limb slide. So it has flavor from the Glock 19 and flavor from the Glock 17. We had to modify or add material to the end of the slide here to make it fit properly with the Glock 19 size dust cover. The G49 has all of the Gen 5 technology, all of the upgrades that we did with our Gen 5 stuff. It has all those innovations. It will use the Glock 19 magazine, which is a 15-round magazine. So essentially, you got a 16-round gun, 15 in the magazine, one in the chamber. You can also run Glock Factory Plus 2 capacity extensions, which would turn that 15-round magazine into a 17-round mag. So now you have an 18-round gun. You have 17 in the magazine, you have one in the chamber, giving you a total of 18 rounds.
Hey guys, this is Mark from Trigger Deck here. We're at SHOT Show Las Vegas here with Canadian Caliber. We got some really exciting new products coming out this year. Seiko and Tika triggers here. Coming out sooner than that, we do have our Ruger RPR trigger here, much anticipated. This will come out for the rimfire and the centerfire models as well. Also very new, coming out even sooner, probably next couple months. It's our REM 700 base trigger. This is our first fixed pound bolt action trigger. It's a fixed 3.5 pound trigger in a die cast housing. We're starting to retail at these at $129. Middle of last year, we did release our AR duties as well. These are our die cast price point triggers for the ARs. They're fixed 3.5. We have single two-stage flat and curved levers, much more forceful reset, and a longer take up on the first stage on the two-stage as well. So we've got our Glock trigger here coming out. So we're still working on development here. This will probably be a release towards the end of this year. If we can see here, the pull weight got a little take up. Boom. Very short reset. Very excited about these ones too. So they will have a few different models of these triggers. So we will have some competition grade ones here at lower pull weights and some more kind of everyday duty kind of triggers.
Hey, I'm here with Canadian Caliber at SHOT Show 2024. What I've got here is the GOAT 15 by Mountain Billy Gun Labs. So this is a shrunk down AR-15 looking. It's not really an AR-15 because it shares none of the common parts. No transition parts at all. It is its own gun. It's a 22 long rifle. It is 20% shorter and smaller than a regular AR-15. It has a full-size rail on it, full-size M-lock. Proprietary mags come in single and 5-round right now. Later this summer, there will be 10-round mags as well. We have a patented safety on this firearm that actually locks the firearm in the safe mode. So if you are putting this gun inside of a backpack or behind your truck in the seat or in the tractor or wherever you might put it, as it is a survival rifle, you can lock this rifle by pulling this knob out, rotating it 180 degrees. Now we're in lock. That safety will not come off. Come back, do the exact opposite operation, back into business. Is our next product that will be out approximately a year to a year and a half, depending on how it goes, is a similar version of the AK-47, which we called the LR-47. Very much similar in the way it works to an AK. Master of Arms, very similar. Safety works. It's all 22 long rifle. So this will be a 5 and a single as well. Possibly a 10 round will come out after that. Suppressors are separate. This barrel is a threaded barrel, so we do have the the GOAT 15 that I was showing you does have a shrouded barrel on it. I forgot to mention there, this is a 7.5-inch barrel with a steel shroud welded on that makes up the 16-inch length to make it a rifle. So super lightweight. This gun weighs 2.5 pounds. Literally, you could put this thing in your backpack and you won't even know you have it with you. We had it at range day yesterday and it was shot often and everybody had the same reaction. It's fun. The AK, we've got a receiver here that's open, and when you look in there, you can see it looks like a little mini, you know, if you look at my fingers for reference, it looks like little mini AK parts. The only difference is these guns, of course, are blowback guns. If you want to check out what we're doing and get new product information, we are at mtnbilly.com.
Hey guys, I'm Katie Godfrey with Kestrel Ballistics. I'm here with Canadian Caliber at the SHOT Show 2024 talking about all of the Kestrel products that we have available. Starting off, I just want to go through the different Kestrels because it's a little confusing. There's a lot of options. You start with the Kestrel 5700. The 5700 is our base model. It holds three gun profiles at a time and a single target. It's really great for entry-level shooters or people that are concerned about the investment. One of the best parts of it is that it's firmware updatable up to the Elite. So the 5700 Elite is coming straight out of the 5700. The difference here is that this gets 30 gun profiles saved in it at a time. You can use multiple targets either through a target card where you do up to 300 customizable targets or a full data card. And you can access all of Applied Ballistics, custom drag models, all the information that you need from Applied Ballistics, plus an accuracy first screen. It has everything that you need for any kind of long range shooting. Then, if you really want to upgrade, you go up to the 5700X. So this was a future-proof product that we developed for SOCOM about 4 years ago. What we did with it was two things. We made the Bluetooth adjustable, so for our SOCOM and for everybody, so that they can reduce what their footprint is. If they're using Bluetooth, they can dial it down. And then the other thing is we put in a bigger processor. This processor allows us at those extreme long ranges to give you solutions a lot faster, and then also be prepared for any kind of new solvers, any kind of new updates to come out. We're always sending out firmware updates on Kestrel. We try and get updates out about every 6 months, whether it's a user request as far as a feature or anything else like that. Now, we also do have the shot timer. We're really excited about the shot timer. This is the KST-1000. It is the last shot timer you'll ever need to buy. It's fully waterproof. It is drop tested to mil standards. It has the 5-year warranty. So everything you get in a Kestrel. But we also added this nice big front display. It has a top display as well. Everything on the back is your microphone and your speakers. So if you're using it as an RO, you're watching that display as you hold it out. Just super awesome. The other great part is this big display. So when you're setting up all of your menus, you can go through, do all of your menu settings. You don't have to worry about long button presses, short button presses. It's all right there for you to see. And it does dry fire. So one of the best features of this is that you can use it for training at home using dry fire. It'll just go right off and start working. So if you have any other questions about Kestrel, or if you're interested in learning more about them, you can always go to kestrelballistics.com. We do also offer online classes for free. There's Zoom classes every month on kestrelballistics.com/classes, and you can learn in depth how to use your Kestrel.
Hey, how's it going? My name's Eric TG, and I am the category manager for professional apparel at 511. I'm here at SHOT Show 2024 with Canadian Caliber, and I'm going to run you through some of our newest products that we're introducing at the show here. One of the big features that we're doing this year is we've introduced last SHOT Show our VXI collection. This is a collection of product that targets top-tier users, so it's really our best technology and best-in-class product to target top-tier users, SWAT, top-end operators. Last year, we launched with only solid colors, so this year we've launched a full multicam version in a colorway. So what you're looking at through here is a fully kitted out guy, as you've seen, with the entire XTU pant and our XTU Rapid with all of our other equipment that we fall in that all merchandises together in a multicam setup. The first piece is one that we did extensive wear testing on and had a lot of feedback from users. This is our XTU pant. First off, this is a nylon Cordura cotton blend that falls under a no melt, no drip certification. So this will not melt onto the skin or hurt the user. It will turn into char cloth and roll off. But it's still very lightweight, it's still very durable, and it has really good stretch, four-way stretch, so it's incredibly stretchy. We've had a lot of our users come back and say they're amazed at how durable and breathable this is and comfortable to wear. Our whole back panel here is filled with an ortholite padding, so it's a super lightweight, thin padding material that supports the back and also helps you give some protection and softness against the gun belt. We have two zip secure pockets here in the back. This is some feedback that came directly from users. We have a two-way fly zip on here. So you fly zip here from the top, and you can also fly zip from the bottom up. This is really important for some users since when you're all kitted out, a lot of times you cannot reach some of your private areas very easily. So instead of having to dig through and underneath all your equipment, you have much easier access. We've got reinforced knife pockets here on the side. And then we go to our cargo pocket configuration. A lot of the pieces on the market right now are very bulky and bulgy. These sit very flat to the user. You have a back bellow that opens straight up here in the back. It allows you to open the pocket up and you can get in with a gloved hand very easily in and out. As you move down, we've got a gusseted crotch for extra mobility. And then you also have venting areas off the cargo pocket to dump heat. So very important to be able to vent. We have some compartmentalization that you can fit a mag in there. And we also have a micro knee adjustment that allows you to adjust the height of the knee pad higher or lower depending on where you need that knee position. We are offering a triple knee pad system. Flexible, but hard layer here that is actually built to pull away. So it won't rip and it won't tear. It'll actually pull away, but it takes some force to do that. So it's difficult to get off, but you can also, will rip away and won't ruin the item. We have this pronging system. It makes it removable and you can add it back on. And then it's soft and flexible, really comfortable, but also hard. We run a full-time ortholite sewn in pad. So you have a 24/7 knee pad all the way available for you. And then for added protection, we have a third layer that has a soft, flexible, traditional knee pad that pops down from underneath. You can lock it in place here with your Velcro here in the back with the Velcro strap. You have a blousing strap to be able to tighten this around the boot if you'd like, but we also provide a lace secure here. So this pulls out and is on elastic here. You can lace this into your boot laces and it keeps this very snug and in position, especially if you're taking shooting positions or you're going down on a knee or climbing or going over walls, whatever the thing, it'll keep your pant cuffed nice and tight. You get a really nice amount of comfortable stretch. And this has been really positive for the guys, especially with the amount of body positions these guys are going in to have that maximum amount of flex. So to go with our XTU pant, we have our XTU Rapid shirt and our XTU long sleeve. We have our traditional Rapid, and then we have a more of a TDU button-up blouse setup. We would call this like a garrison shirt. But what's key here is both of these are constructed from our nylon cotton Cordura blend that is also no melt, no drip. And in this Rapid configuration, it's obviously set up for plate carrier use to maximize breathability and also move moisture and heat away from the body. And you've also got a side pocket zip here with a 4x6 loop panel. In our garrison configuration, we take that body fabric and we place that underneath the arms. And that allows a lot more flexibility with this type of shirt. Same setup as both, but a little bit more different need. One more basic combat where this is more like everyday uniform. This is our Sigurd shirt. The Sigurd is a rugby configuration that also utilizes our CryoTac fabric technology. And CryoTac really refers to it has cooling properties. So it actually allows your skin to stay cool and actually move moisture. There's two things special, really special about this style. First is our collar configuration. We designed this specifically and we have a patent pending for this. This protects against sling burn and any of the backpack and or plate carrier running up on the shoulder, and it protects the base of your neck up to the side of your neck. And you can see the protrusions up here in the front. A lot of times the sling burn ends up at the top of the jaw, but this gives you full coverage. We also reduced the width of the neck opening because some areas when this is too open, you can actually get shell casings down inside. So this allows you to actually make it so it's more secure so you don't get anything that falls down underneath. Super amount of stretch. But you can also see it's fully perforated. And the other combination here is the nylon. So the nylon is something that we call this hydrophobic. That means it will not absorb water. We also built this knowing this a plate carrier would go over the top. So the exterior feel has a little bit rougher and higher denier, whereas the internal has a slightly different configuration. It is much softer hand and is much nicer on the skin. We have this in a short sleeve and long sleeve configuration. All right, this is one of the last items I'm going to show you. It's a new mid-layer for us. This is what we call the XTU LT3. So this is built to go along and wear with our XTU kit. And this is your mid-layer set. You have a nylon stretch dobby here in the body. And then in key areas where there's high abrasion, we have a higher denier polyester that's overlaid on the forearms, on the shoulders, here where you're coming in contact with your plate carrier. And then also here on the back panel where you get abrasion from your gun belt and also your armor panels. Have a grid fleece underneath the arm. This provides stretch, comfort, and breathability, especially if you wear a plate carrier over the top of this. And Primaloft actually mimics down in terms of the way it keeps you warm. So it's the highest amount of warmth you can get for the lowest amount of volume. The other really cool thing about Primaloft is that it's a synthetic and it also mimics wool. So when it does get wet, you can just wring it out and it'll still insulate you very well, even in a wet configuration. We have nice comfort stretch cuffs here. They allow a lot of comfort, but no exaggeration or blown up into your gun area. Adjustable waist cinch here posted into the pockets. And this style will also pack into its own hand pocket into a nice small carryable ball. So this is our XTU LT3 jacket that we are debuting you in fall 24.
Hey there guys, it's David Lowe again from Ternion International in Canada. Day two of SHOT Show and we're doing our product research. Wanted to visit the booth of one of our key suppliers, Hawk Industries. They provide our custom version of the Ternion T870 and 870-1. Wanted to give you a sneak peek of what could be coming down the road depending on what we collaborate on together. No promises, but hey, you know, give us your feedback depending on what you see. Let us know what you like. All right, so let's take a look and see what Hawk has potentially in the future. All right, so here are all versions of the 870. So we could similarly customize our T870s to fit these types of configurations. These are already very familiar to us. We have the T870s and Dash 1s very similarly styled with our custom take on it. Over here, I know some of you have been asking for longer barrels, something more suitable for hunter configuration. So we have these as potential options coming down the road. Longer barrel, bead sight, more traditional wood finish. This might be a good option for you hunters out there. So let us know. MagFed, so the T870-M, it's not these. It's, you know, our custom take on the MagFed T870 is coming in the summertime 2024, but this is Hawk's own versions for the American market, I think. And you know, our MagFed version is based off of these. I like this short barrel here. MagFed 5-round. So you can look for our version of it coming real soon. We have some semi-autos. Now the guys at Hawk, they tell me that this is their own custom design. This isn't based off of the 870 or any other cloned platform, but it is a semi-auto 12 gauge. So again, something that could be very suitable for the Canadian hunters out there, maybe 3-round, 28-inch barrel, bead sight, semi-auto action. All right, and here, if you like MagFed 870 platform shorty, just something to tuck away in your drawer, scare the bad guys away at home, you could do this too. 8-inch barrel, 5-round mag, 870 platform, interchangeable parts. That's a lot of fun. Now this, as it is, will probably be very restricted in Canada, but hey, if you like this type of product, let us know. We'll work with the supplier and RCMP, get a maybe a slightly longer barrel on here, get a classification, but this is definitely a lot of fun. Just something good to play around with here in Vegas. And again, let us know if you see anything you like. Okay, and again, thanks to Canadian Caliber for following us here at SHOT Show today and throughout the week. If you see anything that you like and you would like us, Ternion, to put our spin on it and bring it over to you guys here in Canada or up north in Canada, because I'm in Las Vegas right now, let us know in the comments. I'll talk with the Canadian Caliber team and get all of your feedback. Thanks so much for tuning in and hope to hear from you soon.
Hey everyone, this is Mike Magden with Wiley Eyewear at the 2024 SHOT Show here with Canadian Caliber. Wanted to showcase some of our new products that we have coming out for the year. Some things we're really excited about, some of the new things we've done. So first and foremost, one of the best styles that we've come out with this year, for sure, is the Wiley X Founder. It's in an FDE frame, has three different frame choices for you. Polycarbonate, polarized lenses, tungsten, captivate lenses, which is what our state-of-the-art leading polarization. This is gonna retail for around the $200 mark, so anywhere from $150 to $200 based on the polarization, but matte finishes everywhere, black front, FDE frame, and with the rubberized insert on the temple as well. So that's the Wiley X Founder, named after our founder of the company. The next one that we're really excited about is the Wiley X Recon. So the Wiley X Recon is gonna come in a multitude of colors, three colors to be exact. Gray Wolf is one of the colors that we're coming out with this year. It's a really unique frame, and it has a lot of different angles that you'll see with a lot of different materials that we're using here. So one of the materials we're using here will be our tri-nylon frames with the metal finish and a rubberized temple arm as well. Everything we offer here at Wiley X is gonna be ANSI rated, high velocity, high impact rated eyewear as well. One of the new frames that we're coming out with this year, one of the new styles is gonna be the Wiley X Sierra. Wiley X Sierra features a little ventilation into the lens itself. There's a little cutout into the lens itself with multitude of different lens options, red captivated being one of them. So you can see how unique this lens looks. We're gonna have black ops versions as well, but it's a really sleek design, and you're gonna be able to pick up any of these on WileyX.com.
Hi, my name's Eric with Nightforce, and I'm here with Canadian Caliber at the 2024 SHOT Show, and I just want to show you a new product that we released. This is the configurable field spotting scope. It is a 6-36 F1 spotting scope, so it does have a reticle in it, which we have three different options for that. We have a MIL XTS, an MOA XTS, and the Tremor 4. Those are all spotting scope variants of our rifle scope reticles. So you're able to talk to you, if you're in a shooter spotter scenario, you're able to talk in the same language as your shooter as you're doing the spotting. So 6-36, it has a great magnification range for the kind of the big spotting applications, and then 36 power when you need to get fine. It has an integrated ARCA foot here designed to the RRS dovetail standard, so you can attach this directly to your tripod mount without any additional parts to go on there. The rest of the name, like the field spotting scope part of it, is you can obviously see it's very lightweight, very streamlined, so no snag points on here at all. Weighs only 33.7 ounces without the cage. The cage just adds a little bit more. And then the configurability of it. So this is the spotting scope accessory cage. It has five different mounting faces for M-lock connections of Picatinny rails. You can see over here we have one set up already, giving an example of some things that you can do. We have a Kestrel mounted here onto the side. So if you're spotting and you want to adjust something about the ballistics for your particular shot, you're able to do that right on your spotting scope. We also have a rail that's not demonstrated here, but if you wanted to put any visual augmentation systems out front, you're able to do that. So we have a rail that extends forward. The MSRP on this for the bear spotter, that would be without cage, is $29.50. And then with the cage, which comes with these two Picatinny rails here, is $3,100.
Hi guys, it's Ben Sanderson at Gun Owners of America. We're here at SHOT Show 2024, promoting the no compromise mission that Gun Owners of America is famous for. We're the only no compromise gun lobby in Washington, D.C., fighting for your rights every single day. We've had a great time here. Everyone's been super positive about the no compromise mission. Everyone's been talking about what we can do to fight against the ATS rules, and it's been an awesome show so far. If you want to know more, you can visit our website, gunowners.org, or check us out on social media, also Gun Owners.
Hey, it's Owen with Kodiak Defense. We're down here in Las Vegas, SHOT Show 2024, showing off some of our rifles. We've been getting a lot of Canadians wandering by, a lot of interested Americans seeing what we got. It's been a great time. You can head to KodiakDefense.com if you want to see more, but it's been a great show this year. We hope to see a bunch of people next year.